Welcome. First of all, this is the first video I do in English, so please excuse any mistakes. What I try to build here is an AIS receiver. Since I go sailing sometimes for hobby, it's really nice to see the other boats around you, especially at night. Commercial products are very expensive, so I built a AIS receiver using a DVB-T stick, a Raspberry Pi, and a self-made antenna. First goal is to build an antenna which is sensitive to 162 MHz, and I found many designs on the internet, but I wasn't satisfied at all with any of them. In theory, they look really nice, but if you measure them, they really suck. So I found a guy. The credits come at the end. He is into a so-called flower pot design, and he is into amateur radio, which runs at I think 140 MHz. And I emailed him and asked him if he could calculate me an antenna for 162 MHz. And he sent me the following design. The unshielded length should be 415 millimeters. The shielded length should be 406 millimeters, and the coil should have 11.5 turns on a 20 millimeter former. As former, I use a pipe for installation. The cable is the usual RG58 cable, and I drilled some holes into the installation pipe to wrap the cable around. The pipe is really flexible, so it's no problem to get the wire through. The difficult part is to fiddle the wire through the longer part of the pipe, but you will see in a moment that with a rope and some knots and tape, it's no problem. So I built the antenna approximately to the length I need. Just mark the points where the cable should get into the wire at the pipe, the pipe, right? And then I have to mark the length of the unshielded part and the shielded part together, which is 415 and 406 millimeters together. First, put the rope through. It goes quite a bit, but then it got stuck, so I used compressed air to get it all the way through. I increased the speed a bit, so the video shouldn't get too boring. I here now and use the compressed air. So now I have it through, almost. Okay, then measure the length. It's a bit difficult to mark it because a black pen on a black wire is a problem, but I use the writing on the cable to mark approximately the 406 millimeters of the shielded length. Then wrap the turns around, hold it in place and pull the cable through the pipe. I tried several knots and so on, but the best thing that works is tape. So now the 11.5 turns. count them and pull it through. That's really no problem. Very easy and smooth. Just measure the length before and then everything should fit. Now adjust the whole thing to length, so I have my mark on the where the cable gets into the pipe. So there we go. Then just pull the inside wire straight a bit so it gets stretched, and you could attach the antenna to some point, either on the board or on the wall or so. It's important that the coil is straight, so I use a wooden stick, wrap around some tape and push it into the inside of the tube, so the coil is lined and in straight. I have to remove this later to tune the antenna, but for now it's just if it fits. So, finished. The next step would be to attach a connector. The input of the DVB-T stick is 75 ohms, but I use a 50 ohms BNC connector because I can attach this easier to my impedance analyzer I have at work. This is just to show how I soldered it on. Mounted, finished. Before I go to the impedance analyzer, I tested the setup. This is the stick I use, a Synergy T stick from TerraTech, Black Edition. This is a adapter from BNC to TV. And you see STL sharp. So I can connect the BNC connector, and now you see the noise of the antenna. It's really good, actually. So I went on to tune the antenna. I went to the lab, hang it freely into the room. This is the impedance analyzer I use. It's from 10 hertz to 500 megahertz. And now I have to calibrate it and align it and set the ranges and so on. It takes 10 minutes, so I speeded it up like 600%. But it's a really accurate tool. So now I attach the antenna, and then you should see there is a peak. Yeah, it's sensitive. It's now I switch to SVR, which is the, I think, the important part. And you see it has a resonance at about 159 megahertz. So I'm 3 megahertz off just by building it without any real measurements. So now it's too low frequency, so I have to reduce the inside length of the shielded part. So I have to pull the wire a bit through and wrap the coil back so I can pull the cable out on the other side. And once I did this, you see the resonance is at approximately 162 megahertz. Now we go to SVR, just adjust the scale, and it's not this bad. So I have 1.2 to 1.1 SVR, that's not so bad. I tuned the antenna later a bit better, but this is for the first time, it's okay. Next, I tested my setup. This is the box. I have everything. Just cables and the stick and a network card, because the one of my computer is broken. Then the Raspberry Pi and the DVB-T, the GPS receiver, the Bluemax one. Now plug the card in. Attach power. It's the Bluemax is a Bluetooth the GPS receiver, and it can be read out by USB. So I'm using this. And the Raspberry runs the RTLFM, the AIS decoder, and the KPLEX to receive and multiplex the AIS data with the GPS data and send it to my OpenCPN. On the Raspberry runs also a DHCP server, which I, by replugging the cable, I see it has now the right IP address. And then I can start my OpenCPN. And if I go to the NEMA raw data on this port, you see it's already sending GPS data, no valid data, because I don't receive da anything. So this is the field test, the same setup I did in my lab. In the field, I went to a bridge near Dresden and plugged in everything. This is my laptop, this is the antenna. It just hangs, I think, about 4 meters above water level at the back of my car. Here you see the CPU usage of the RTL library and the first AIS data. I don't have a map of this area, a C map of this area, so there is no overlay on my chart plotter. But I found several ships which distances really far away. This is 1.6 nautical miles. 4.6 miles, this is really far away. You have to know there are a lot of trees and buildings between me and the ships, so it's not a straight line of sight. You will see in a moment when I turn around with my camera and look in the direction where I see the ships. And then I was really impressed that I got a catch with 7.3 nautical miles. You see right now, this is really, really far away, and it's driving. This is the direction, if you look, where I got the signals. And these are the catches. My position is the red circle. You see at the top left, and this the other ones are the positions I received from other ships, with the most far away 7.29 nautical miles away. So you see between me and the far away point are a lot of buildings and roads, so I think this result I got is really good. I'm going on a boat to go sailing in I think a month, so I will test the equipment there, and then I think I make another video how far I got on real conditions. Thank you for watching. Bye.